Hi friends, good morning. So welcome to our next tutorial on AppWrite. So today we'll concentrate on one of the major and a very very important topic, that is runtime permission. So what is runtime permission? This runtime permission is very very important, but first we'll create one project. While creating the project, we'll discuss about something typically about this. So I'm creating one new project with name of runtime permissions. So it's very very important, just I'm giving the name as runtime, and here I'm creating Java project. See, meanwhile this creating of this project, we'll discuss something about this runtime permissions. So runtime permission is nothing but it's asking, while running application, it's asking the permissions from the user input, like location, contacts, gallery, means internal memory, external memory, like so many, around 10 to 12 different permissions are there. So those permissions it can ask. But why this is required? Why not directly? So previously, this is without asking the user permission only, it's taking the permission from user side. What happens? If here, if I take without user permission, if I took context permission in my application, what happens without user permission, I can able to read all of your contacts data into my application. So I may use legal or illegal. So because of that, nowadays from Android 6.0 onwards, runtime permissions are mandatory. Without runtime permissions, nowadays application could not accepted. So must and should, whenever you are using location or contacts, messages, internal memory, external memory, like gallery accessing, and whenever you are using map, latitude, longitude, and whenever you are using camera. So for these all aspects, you must and should request the permission from user side. Whenever as a user, if he enables, then only we can access that in our application, otherwise it could not. So that how it's happened, we can see programmatically here now. So this is ready. Then in this XML, just I'll took only one button. Once you click on that button, we can able to write here that, so linear layout with orientation as vertical. Now I'm removing this, just I want to drag and drop only one button. Also we'll took here data binding. So this I'm giving this permission, this permission. So ID also I'm giving you as a same. Then here now I'm adding this data binding. So just I'm adding layout here. So layout added here. Then whenever it's a data binding, we need to enable the data binding here. So now within the build types, I'm enabling here data binding. So dot enable equal to true. Just I'm enabling the data binding. So just I'm clicking on the sync now. So once you sync now, the data binding can be enabled. If it is enabled in my main activity, I'll write the action for this. So here, first step in the main activity is as usual, just we can enable the binding first. After enabling the binding, we can write something this. See here now with the name of XML, that is activity main binding, see activity main binding, something binding as generated here. Now here we need to set this main binding equal to data binding util dot. So here now we need to apply context. Now just I want to apply the listener for the button, so that is main binding dot permission dot set on click. So whenever user click on that button, here I am requesting like a few permissions. Same way remaining all permissions can be also applicable here, but I am requesting few permissions. First, whenever user requests, just I am adding this if check permission. This is my defined, user defined. My defined is nothing but here user defined. Just I am checking with this check permission is there. Then I am adding this check permission. So whenever user accept this as what we are doing, if it is permission is granted, then here directly I will write the toast. Simply for our answer means here we'll write our own code what we want expecting. So here granted, just I'm writing this permissions granted, that's it. Else if it is not granted, then it will execute the else case. Here I'm writing this request permission, even though this is also my defined, user defined only. So I'm defining here request permission. Then with this name, I'm creating one method. So that method has created outside of onCreate method. So it's created this. So what is that? Request permission. So now here I'm requesting the permission. How we can request the permission? So these permissions we can request from activity compact. So that activity compact means from the activity level, we are requesting the permission which activity we need on this particular position. We are requesting the permission. So that activity permission, activity compact, here we are requesting dot. So what we are doing here, request, see activity compact dot request permission. So then in that, it's a activity, that is activity is nothing but your context comma permissions in array format, and finally it's a request code. Why it's a array format means I may request one permission or I may request multiple permissions. Because of that, in that first one is the context, second is the array format, and third is a request code. So here first we should write here this main activity dot this. I'm writing this main activity dot this comma. Then now here, how many permissions you want, that many is. Just I'll write this new string array format. So in this array, I'm requesting this permissions. So what are the permissions? We request some write external storage. So write underscore external storage comma, like here this is one external storage. So like this, so many is there. Same way internal storage, same like read calendar, read call log, read contacts, then record audio, record video, record audio. Like this location permission and all, whatever, how many you can, that many you can apply. Here I am applying few sample. Then finally that outside of this place. It's some request code. So just I'm writing this request code. So this request code I'm defining as one integer value. So that is int request code equal to 1. Means it's a giving this success failure like that. If you are giving this request code is 1. So then after this here now this is it's a boolean. It's a giving this true or false. So outside of this here we need to create one public boolean. So here so within this boolean we need to ask what are the permissions you are writing there above. That you need to write, that is int or yes result something equal to, here we need to check the permission context, same context compact what we used above, that context compact dot check self permission, means permission is granted or not, we need to check that. So what is that permission? Here also it's the first is the context, then second. Here what is the first is there, the same permission we can write here. So what is the first permission here? Write external storage. Like this, how many permissions are there? Those many you need to write here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we need to write here total 5. Already one is there. So second, third, fourth and five. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. Means total 5. So this it can change. Instead of this, it should come this read permission. Then read call log. So then read contacts. Then record audio. Record audio like this permissions. So these many permissions here we are asking that request. Then it's a boolean, so it is expecting that some return type. So we should give here return type, that is res equal to, means here it's saying this true or false, the permission is granted or not. So that is from the package manager. So it should be giving the package manager level. So I'm taking this package manager dot, so permission granted. So I'm checking like this, and we should satisfy all the conditions. So I'm going with this, and so remaining 4, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here 2 and here 3, here is the 1, 2, 3. Here is the 1, 2, 3, and here is the 4. Then last it's the end of the statement. Like this. Means here we asking that permission is granted or not. It's this. Then finally, after this, we should write one more extra permission.
But why did you
just write that? That is here.